So the conceit of the show is to give figurative flowers to our Black legends who have not gotten the recognition that they deserve. But we also want to give you some literal flowers.
Thank you for everything that you have done.
Oh my God, they're beautiful.
And they're tulips. A little birdie told me that they were your fave.
How sweet.
Yes.
You know, it's so strange that this is my third nomination. Mm-hmm. And the first one and the second one, flowers flooded my front door immediately.
Uh-huh. Wow.
This year,
nothing.
Text messages. We're in a new time. People send birthday cards and greeting cards through, you know.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes it's nice to have something tactile, you know. Something you can
like
look at and see.
Like a bouquet of tulips.
Precisely like a bouquet of tulips.
Like a bouquet.
Absolutely. As somebody who's been nominated before, what does this particular nomination for a movie about Afrofuturism, the likes that I've never seen before, like, does it feel different? Is it more meaningful?
Well, I think that the Black Panther represented the same type of enthusiasm that we had for the Afrofuture, African diaspora, the same enthusiasm that we had for Malcolm X and for Amistad, but it wasn't as global, it wasn't as big, it wasn't as well received as the Black Panther. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, when I had conversations with Ryan Coogler about, you know, what we were trying to do, it wasn't something that was unfamiliar to any of us. Mm. We all knew what Afrofuture was. We all knew what it meant to celebrate Kwanzaa. We all knew what the last poets was all about.
I
mean, we all
poets.
Knew about, you know, the revolution will not be televised. Mm-hmm. You know, it's something that's been very near and dear in the Black community, you know. We all go to church on that day where the choir all dresses in African attire, and that's just part of the culture that I think has been embraced and celebrated throughout our lives. Mm-hmm. And we just wanted to embrace it in this film and elevate it and connect it back to Africa. So, you know, as you travel through Wakanda, you don't see any of those dark, light, bad, good. We didn't really have any of those classic roles in the Black Panther to sort of say, because you have natural hair, you're not beautiful, and there's someone over here with straight hair, or because you're darker skin, there's someone over here. We didn't actually even deal with those kind of subjects and stories. We dealt with honoring Africa and honoring a fictitious place that one could look at and take pride in, whomever you were. You could actually say, I feel very Wakandan, and people would know you felt very good about yourself.
Yeah. So the very first listing on your IMDb page is Spike Lee's School Days.
Yes.
And I understand that you are a graduate of an HBCU, Hampton, correct?
Yes.
So how did you draw on your experience, and what were the most important parts of that story or experience to capture?
When I went to Hampton, I kind of gravitated towards the things that I felt like inspired me. And because I was very inspired as a high school student, I was in lots of, you know, African diaspora type programs, Uhuru Sasa, where we learned Swahili, and we had African drumming, and those were conducted by college students that came together and brought kids from the inner city and, like, kind of taught them about culture. And I learned about Sonia Sanchez and Nikki Giovanni.
Yes,
so, you know, School Days came about through my meeting Spike Lee and going to New York to start filming and start creating the look of HBCU, which I knew quite well, having gone to Hampton. I could actually kind of, like, you know, balance the idea of what the gamma rays would look like and what the gammites would look like, and good and bad hair, and the jigaboos and the wannabes, because we were actually making a commentary about that system and that that sorority college life. So I feel like we all, as filmmakers, were on the other side of it, designing it to speak to some other kind of messages that it was projecting.
What was it like working with Spike Lee?
Well, I've done 12 films with Spike.
What is it like working with Spike Lee?
You could say that in the beginning, Spike mentored me because I had no film experience before I started working with him, and I went straight in as a designer. Mm-hmm. So there were lots of things that Spike told me to look out for. Like make what? Sure you have multiples for this scene because there's going to be a stunt. You know, make sure this is bold and colorful because we want to have a different balance to Malcolm X's life as an early kind of hustler to when he becomes a national speaker. Mm-hmm, so mm-hmm. I feel like every time I go back to 40 Acres and work with Spike Lee, I'm always learning something, finding out about new art, trying new artistic ideas. Always has been an enriching experience.
Yeah.
And so 12 films with those kinds of experiences, I feel have really kind of crafted me too as an artist.